When Narasimhavaraj and I were in Los Angeles, when we were in ISKCON, they started a Prabhupada Remembrance Night, where they would talk about various pastimes and different humorous things that Prabhupada had done. But the problem was that it was just so sentimental and so many just stories. There is no substance to it. So Narasimhavaraj stopped going, and of course I didn't go then. Some years later, when we were outside of ISKCON, we had our ashram established in Vrindavan, Rupanuga Bhajan Ashram. I was returning from there alone, and I decided, since my flight was into Los Angeles, that was what was arranged, that I would go to the Rath Yatra, which was being held in L.A. And after, I believe it was the same night, same day as the Rath Yatra, that evening, I was in the bookstore, and I was talking with a godbrother. And we were talking philosophy, but everything that I mentioned, he would quote Srila Prabhupada, and he'd say, well, in this type of voice, Srila Prabhupada says in the second canto, such and such, such and such. And I thought, at the time, I was thinking, well, Prabhupada says that, but what do you think? Don't you have any realizations? Don't you understand what you've read? Haven't you digested it? So that was my thought at the time, that he may have the form down, he memorized so many things, but not the substance. So again, many years later, when we established this ashram, Govindji Gardens, and there was one neighbor girl who attended the programs regularly here, and I had heard that she had memorized the entire Bhagavad Gita, all the slokas. She knew them all. So I thought, all right, let me talk to her about this. And I found out that she only knew the Sanskrit. She had no idea of the content. So I asked her, Bhagavad Gita 7.3, Manushinam Sahasreshu, what's the meaning of that? And she looked at me blankly. I don't know the meaning of any of the verses, but she had them all memorized by heart. So it's one thing to memorize, it's a wholly different thing. A completely different thing to process them and to understand them and realize them so that you can speak from them. Actually, this is earlier in years, 1982. This was the height of the tension between ISKCON and Srila Sridhar Maharaj. So many devotees had gone and asked questions and gotten answers. And then because some of those devotees actually were not of the best intentions, it caused some dissatisfaction in ISKCON, and the leaders were upset about this. So they were trying to go to Srila Sridhar Maharaj and tell him what to do. You can't, you know, say this, or you shouldn't initiate anyone and like that. So they were instructing him. So that's the mood that Yasomati Nandan walks into, and he actually came with the same agenda of some sort. Srila Sridhar Maharaj asked Yasomati Nandan, why did you come to Krishna consciousness? And he replied, well, Prabhupada taught us, and he goes, what did he teach you? He said, he taught us Krishna. Who is Krishna? What is Krishna? And he said, well, Krishna consciousness.
What is that? What is the idea? Sarva dharmam parityajya. And the highest goal, sajanam arya patham chahitta bhejur mukunda padami. Are you acquainted with this sloka of Bhagavatam, which is said by Uddhava about the gopis of Vrindavan, their qualification? Are you acquainted with this sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam?
No, kindly tell me.
So you should be connected, and you should have connection with the highest ideas we have got in Gaudiya Vaishnava. I had to go, what is our destination? What for we have come to ISKCON? A general call, Thami Maharaj has given to so many, crushing as the pride of the present scientific civilization. But what for? What is our aim, highest aim? You must be conscious of that. What for you have come? You soldiers, you are arrayed to fight with Maya. But what for? What is your aim? What is the conception? There are so many conceptions. Christianity conception, Islam conception, this Buddhist conception.
Our thinking is
conception, Shankaraite conception, so many. But what is Krishna consciousness that Swamiji Maharaj gave to you?
Right.
He captured your mind through preaching through Krishna consciousness.
Right.
And what did you find peculiar in Krishna consciousness that you left your previous religious ideas and joined Swami Maharaj? He took so much risk. What is that Krishna consciousness?
Oh.
You must know that.
Yes, we know whatever
not
Prabhupada
heavy,
has taught
not
us.
Heavy, not taking the
What's
name
that?
Of Prabhupada. Not taking the name of
Krishna
Prabhupada.
Is the Supreme Lord.
Krishna is the Supreme Lord. That is a vague word. One will say Allah is the Supreme Lord. Another says Jesus is the Supreme Lord.
He has a name, form, pastimes, paraphernalia. They are not different from Krishna.
To know what is Krishna consciousness, back to Godhead. What is that Godhead?
We are being educated about that in ISKCON. We are.
That education is not a mere passion, that is reality.
Srila Sridhar Maharaj is relating how I knew Prabhupada, your Prabhupada, before he joined the Gaudiya Mutt. And I knew him up to his last days. So I think I know him better than you. Bhaktivinod foretold. Then Prabhupada began, and your Swami Maharaj, he came with flying colors. And again, we know the result.